Jaw repositioning surgery, otherwise known as orthognathic surgery, is one of the most life-changing and rewarding procedures we do. Let's check out a full surgical case today on The Open Reduction. Welcome to The Open Reduction, your channel, everything oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton, and today we're going to watch a Lafort 1 osteotomy and a maxillary advancement surgery. The surgery was done to correct an underbite and improve the patient's bite, function, and overall appearance. This patient is a 24-year-old male who has a class 3 malocclusion, meaning that his top jaw sits behind his bottom jaw. The official diagnosis is maxillary hypoplasia. He saw an orthodontist who determined his bite could not be corrected with braces alone due to the skeletal discrepancy. The patient was subsequently referred to my office. I analyzed the skeletal relationship and agreed. Surgery was the only way to correct this bite. His dentition was leveled and aligned by his orthodontist using Invisalign, and then I saw him back for an online virtual surgery. The virtual surgery established the ideal post-operative position of his maxilla, and then a custom splint was fabricated to use in the operating room. This procedure is done in the operating room under general anesthesia using a nasal intubation. Since this patient is in Invisalign, I placed Eric arch bars to aid in the surgery and in the post-operative treatment. Once the patient was prepped and draped, I made a mucosal incision from first bicuspid to first bicuspid. I then used the Bovie electrocautery unit to dissect through the submucosal tissue and the periosteum. Once I was able to palpate the bone, I used a periosteal elevator to expose the maxillary bone. Once the periosteum is reflected, I established the location of the infraorbital foramen and nerve. I place a Selden retractor along the lateral aspect of the nasal passage. It's crucial to protect the nasal mucosa and the nasoendotracheal tube. I then use the reciprocating saw to make the initial cuts. The osteotomy is going to be superior to the root apices of the maxillary canine, the longest root in the maxilla. This osteotomy separates the lateral maxillary buttresses and the piriform rims. I then use the guarded osteotome to separate the lateral nasal wall and also the septum from the vomer posteriorly. I used curved osteotome to separate the maxilla from the pterygo maxillary junction posteriorly. Now it's time to down fracture the maxilla. Before we mobilize the maxilla, I want to take a minute to ask you to subscribe to my channel, The Open Reduction. The channel covers all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery and is a great resource for students, professionals, and patients. By subscribing and hitting the like button, you're letting me know that you're benefiting from this content, and it also helps this content reach more people. I attempted to down fracture the maxilla, but there was some resistance, so I got out the osteotomes again. Yeah, The maxilla is subsequently released and became independent of the facial skeleton. I pull the maxilla inferiorly and remove all bone that will interfere with the planned advancement. I also reduce the midline and vomer with a reduction burr to allow plenty of room for the inferior aspect of the nasal septum. I want to free up the tissue and minimize the risk of relapse, so I use the Roe disimpaction forceps to manipulate the maxilla in several planes. The blood supply to the down fractured segments is the ascending palatine branch of the facial artery and the anterior branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery. I can advance the maxilla without resistance, and it fits into the splint passively. I lock the maxilla and splint into place with heavy elastics, and then I fixate the maxilla in its new position with plates and screws. I place two plates at the piriform rim and two plates at the lateral maxillary buttress and secure them with 7mm screws. I need to confirm that the occlusion is stable and the condyles are sitting in the fossa appropriately. So I take the patient out of interdental fixation and check the bite. I'm very happy with this new occlusion. I then irrigate everything thoroughly and close the soft tissue using a VY technique. This will help maintain the height and thickness of the upper lip. I followed this patient for several weeks after the case, and at week 6, I took off the arch bars. His bite looks excellent, and he's very happy with his new appearance and function. Thanks for watching today's episode. Please click that like button and subscribe to the channel for more content, oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.